Pakistan does not have to make a critical choice between the Western bloc, as was the case during the Cold War, or the China bloc. And Chinese themselves are discouraging Pakistan to make the geostrategic game look like a zero-sum competition. So Pakistan has the opportunity to keep its feet in whatever is happening around in the area. Of course, in doing this, Pakistan has to go by the dictates of its national interest. And so it's not an either-or situation for Pakistan. So Pakistan can remain CPAC and build on its solid foundation of friendship with China. But at the same time, Pakistan does not have to rebuff others, for example, Russia or the European Union or the even for that matter the United States, because Pakistan's interest in those are served by becoming part of these multiple alliances Pakistan should be. So there is a bit of a flexibility that Pakistan has in choosing its alliances.
Thank you.
I give the floor to Ambassador Fazlullah.
I'm very impressed with all the projects and the figures that you have given. Absolutely. But I'd like to know, we've been talking about CPAC as a game changer and now a big changer. What is Pakistan doing to make it a game changer? I see all the projects on the drawing board, and some of them being implemented. What about the human resource development, capacity building? How are we going to present our human resource utilized for CPAC projects? We haven't yet started.
Yes.
I'm trying to find a statement which would take me from a situation where we haven't yet started to not figure out as the actual situation. Yeah. So, in terms of CPAC, and as I said earlier, we were given certain targets and we wanted to go incrementally. We wanted to go in terms of development of the projects face to face and also in terms of developing our human resources. But now coming to the energy sector, the coal projects coming in, it was the first time that Pakistan was having this coal development. So we realized that there is dearth of human resource available for those projects. So what we did immediately was to send our fresh graduates from here to China, and there's a big bag, about 300 engineers. And the first group has come back, they've been employed in Saibar and forecasting project. So this is in terms of sending the trend right now. We work with the Chinese embassy, and some of the imperials and data that's available on our website is right now there are 20,000 Pakistani students being trained in China, and there are different faculties, and of course, in terms of the I gathered this data that how many in the USA there were around only 5,000, and how many in UK around 9,000. So the number is increasing as we speak for people going to China, and the government of Pakistan, along with the Chinese, is working on it. So there's the process of going to China, learning languages, learning culture, well, it's a process. Also, our webinars and some of the vocational training institutions, I totally agree with you they have to improve. We have to improve the capacity. But I believe, as a university teacher also, I believe that we should not expect all our graduate women to be keen to CPAC. If there was no CPAC, weren't we required to improve our vocational training anyways, because the world is changing. as soon as they step out of Nihau and Nihama. So we have to work on our language skills, we have to work on, but what we're doing is as step one, we send certain faculty to China and also students. We work with, as I said in my presentation, we have actually worked with HEC, aligning their long-term plan with our vision, their vision 2025 with our long-term plan. So that exercise, that academic exercise, scholars at the university faculty, that has been done. We have on our part in terms of industrial cooperation, in the joint working group, we have kept ET peptides and now the creation as one of the agenda items, and we have kept them in the group of members. So these are the kind of steps, and I think we have taken few steps. We are in the right direction. We are behind in many ways, but that's not only because of CPEC. We have to improve our vocational training, looking at some of the changes that are coming, looking at our neighbors in India, look at India in many other ways. So government is doing that work. We've had a series of seminars to look at how this process is taken. So I would say maybe in terms of step one to 10, we are there at step three right now. And perhaps in the next 2 to 3 years, we should be close to step five. The long way, we have identified the areas in which we have to improve the capacity, like maritime tourism, language skill and tourism, services sector and tourism sector, and some of the other areas. And I can share with, it's available on my website for the study that we've done and the areas that we have identified. We believe some of the studies believe that the overall job creation would be around 700,000. But in terms of capacity, we are at 30%.